Hi book lovers, welcome back to my channel. This is the historical romance readathon vlog. I know a couple of you have been wanting me to do more reading vlogs, so I'll try to do that, starting with this one. If you didn't know, if you didn't hear about the historical romance readathon, this is one that I'm co-hosting with my friends Lisa and Jessica. Lisa from Remarkably Lisa and Jessica from Peace Love Books. It's running from March 16th through the 22nd, a week long, and all you have to do is read historical romances. We also came up with a bingo game just to make things a little bit more fun, a little bit more challenging. So this is gonna be my reading vlog for the week. I'm not sure if I'll be filming every day. I guess it depends on how much I read that day, but coincidentally, this is also the week that everyone is self-isolating because of the coronavirus, COVID-19. So yeah, it sucks that all of that is going on, but I guess that means that I have more time to read for the readathon at home, and it will probably take my mind off of things. So to recap my TBR, I have 4 audiobooks that I really want to get to and 3 paperbacks. My paperbacks are Devil's Bride by Stephanie Lawrence, Hearts of Flame by Joanna Lindsay, which is our readathon buddy read. I think me and Lisa and Jessica are thinking of doing like a live chat to talk about this book and the readathon as a whole. And then my last paperback is The Rakes. I have a couple other Lisa Kleypas books that I have in mind that I might read depending on whether I get bored with these 3 books or I finish them early. Don't know if that will happen or not, but we'll see. And then my audiobooks, I have A Daring Arrangement by Joanna Shoup, which is book 1 in her 400 series. I have 2 Beverly Jenkins books, Breathless, which is book 2 in the Old West series, which I've read books 1 and 3 of, so this is the last book that I still need to read. And the other one is Indigo, which is a standalone. And then my last audiobook is, of course, Tessa Dare. I have The Governess Game, which is book 2 in her Girl Meets Duke series. Also the one book that I still haven't read yet in the series. So this readathon is basically me catching up on a couple series, unfinished series. I actually timed it perfectly when I went to borrow the audiobooks from my library because I saw a couple of them were on hold. Like a couple weeks ago, they had maybe 2 weeks left to be on hold, so I went on that just to make sure that I'd be able to have them by the time the readathon started. I also put on hold Joanna Shoup's other Gilded Age historical romance series, the first book in her Uptown Girl series, but that one I still have 2 weeks left to wait, so I probably won't be able to get to it in time. Just depends on how fast that person in front of me listens to it. I'm a very fast listener these days because I've been listening to audiobooks at 2.5 speed, sometimes 3 times speed. I used to listen to normal speed like one times, but I don't know how I ever managed that because that is so slow for me these days. But yeah, because I listen to them really fast, I finish audiobooks in less than 2 days. So yeah, this first day I am planning on reading The Rakes, which I also own the e-arc of. It's just so much easier for me to read on my Kindle, especially since I love highlighting too. And then my first audiobook is gonna be A Daring Arrangement by Joanna Shoup. If you're joining in on the readathon, let me know. Let me know what books you're reading, what you loved, and I will keep you updated. I haven't quite finished any of my books yet. I'm almost done with A Daring Arrangement by Joanna Shoup, and I'm liking it. I can't say that I love it. Maybe if I read it, it might feel differently. I mean, the narrators are fine. I enjoy them. It's like half speaking with a British accent because of the heroine, and half with an American accent because of the hero. This one is gonna be counting as my Gilded Age square for the bingo. It's also counting for the set outside of London square since it takes place in New York City. Also, I forgot to mention Lenore Bell, who is a historical romance author. I've read one of her books. I read One Fine Duke last year and adored it. She was so nice and messaged me about helping us host a giveaway of 10 of her books. I mean, by the time this vlog will be up, the giveaway will be over, but if you haven't read Lenora Bell yet, please check her out. She's awesome and so, so generous. But yeah, the book is okay so far. Like, not bad. I'm enjoying it. It's got a fake engagement between the main characters. The heroine wants to marry this artist that is not of her class. So in order to do that, she makes a deal with the hero who is an American. She thinks he's gonna be like the worst fiance ever, which will, you know, shock her parents so much into allowing her to marry that artist that she's in love with. On Julius's part though, he wants to be engaged to Nora to elevate his status. He has some scheme for revenge that he wants to do, and also I think he could count as a rise to riches hero because he's a self-made man. If you like fake relationship romances, fake engagement romances, you might enjoy this one. It is so funny though, when Julius and Nora first met, he was completely drunk, and that's why Nora thinks that Julius will be a terrible fiance, but he's actually becoming like the best fiance ever, and she's getting annoyed at him for doing so because the whole point is for him to shock her parents. But yeah, it's like them slowly falling in love. The hero is very anti-love though, so it's gonna take a while for him to finally accept that. As for the Reykaz, oh man, I had such high hopes for this one because we get a female Rake. She's a radical and a liberal, all about women's equality and having amazing affairs. But I am having such a hard time getting into this. It's just kind of boring, to be honest. Not much is happening. The romance isn't really there. I love the contrast though between the main characters. He is a single father, very like responsible. Adam is a total sweetheart and I adore his kids. Serafina is of course the female Rake. She's not unlikable, but I'm just having a hard time connecting with her character, I guess. She drinks a lot, and that's not exactly what I was expecting to read about. She has some drinking problems in this, and nothing seems to be resolving from that. So this is a bit of a struggle. Hoping it gets better soon. Also, don't mind me. Pretty much haven't left the house. Stay in bed all day and try to read. But at least with the audiobooks, I am feeling a little bit more productive. So update on what I've read. I finally finished A Daring Arrangement, and I liked it. I'm gonna give it 3.5 stars. I sadly didn't love it as much as I wanted to. Like the first book, the first novella that I ever read from Joanna Shoup, I loved. But this one didn't really do it for me as much, but it was still good, just not great. It was really fun and cute, but I think for me, the hero just took a little bit too long to finally realize that he's in love. I just wanted him to do something about it sooner. And update on the Reykaz. Barely made a dent on it. I've only been reading a couple pages at a time. I'm struggling. I don't know why. If it's because of the book itself or I'm just not in a mood to be reading. I know a lot of people have been struggling to read this week despite staying home. The current events are just not conducive to some, you know, light and happy reading. But for my next audiobook, I'm gonna get started on Breathless by Beverly Jenkins. This is book two in the Old West series, which I've really enjoyed. I read book three last year and loved it. This is one of the few series that I read out of order. And then I read book one for our Ravished by Romance book club read that happened a couple months ago. And that one I really enjoyed too, so I have high hopes for this book. It will be my first time listening to one of these books in audio. I read books one and three, so I don't know if it'll make a difference, whether it will be better or worse. We'll see. The series is Western historical romance, so in America. I think it's somewhere around Arizona. The heroine of Breathless, Portia, is actually the niece from the heroine of book one. I honestly didn't really connect the dots until just now because I read book three first. By the end of book one, the heroine's two nieces come to live with her, and then it's those two nieces that get their stories in books two and three. So this is Portia's romance, and she is a little bit not uptight but very like subdued. She doesn't want romance or love like her sister does. She just wants to be able to run her hotel, which she is the manager of, and also live a very respectful and peaceful life, because growing up she and Reagan's mother was a prostitute and she was pretty awful to them. Their mother was basically about to sell her daughters to these disgusting men before they were sent away. So I will update you guys when I finish this audiobook. Hey, I am back. I'm not quite finished with Breathless, but I'm really enjoying it. Maybe not as much as books one and three, but it's still good. Cause like, I like Kent, but he's not my favorite of Beverly Jenkins' heroes. He does have the sweetest nickname for Portia though. He calls her Duchess, and it makes me so happy every time he calls her that. But for this book, I am gonna count it as also another book set outside of London, a rake hero. Kent is very much a rake hero. He was the biggest player before he was sent to prison. They do mention like his conquests a lot though. I'm not sure why so many times it's been mentioned. So that's a little bit annoying, but I mean, Portia, you can still tell that Portia is it for him now. I love Portia, she's great. Their romance is pretty slow going. I think Beverly Jenkins usually writes slow burn romances. The romance is slow, the story itself is slow. It's just not overly dramatic. It's basically like a day in the life of a black woman living in the Old West. This is another book that is published after 2000, another book in a series, and I'm also going to be checking off the POC main character box and the author of color box. So I am making my way through this little bingo card. I'll probably finish this one really soon, so I'll update you guys tomorrow on it. God knows when I'll be finishing the Rakehest because I still haven't finished. Hey y'all, welcome back. I have just finished recording my video, doing a little mini book tour all about my historical romance books. So that should be going up today. Probably the one video that I'll be uploading this week for the readathon, just because I haven't really had that much time to film and edit. I've been trying to focus on reading the Rakehest, which is still taking me forever. Trying to listen to my audiobooks, just get through my TBR for the readathon, and also I've been distracted by all these YouTube videos, doing little walkthroughs of Animal Crossing. That game is coming out at the end of the week, but I don't have a Switch, so I'm just gonna be crying over everyone who gets to play it. As for my books, I finished Breathless, the audiobook. It was good. I'm giving it 4 stars. Not as good as the other two books in the series. It's pretty steamy. Portia gets to learn all about her sensuality through Kent, who wants her very badly. Again, it's a very slow romance. Portia is very distrustful of men because of what her mother put her through. Although it's very interesting, like, how different Portia and her sister Reagan came out from that whole ordeal. They're pretty much opposites in their outlooks of life. So Portia doesn't really want to have anything to do with men, with marriage, but Kent is just determined to win her heart and prove to her that he is absolutely meant for her and treasure her and treat her like the Duchess that he calls her. It was just really nice, really sweet. If you're a fan of the books in the series, you will more than likely enjoy this one as well. I am finally halfway through the Rakehest. It was slow going, but I made it. Still not much happening in this book though, especially romance wise. Serafina is still still a drunk, so she's not really doing anything in terms of the romance, whereas Adam actually is and trying to build a relationship with her, but she is very much anti-love, anti-marriage. She gets jumpy when the men that she has affairs with start to cling on her or start to be sweet on her. She's like, nope, can't do it, get out. That's different, which is nice, but I was really hoping that she would feel differently for this hero, but she's treating him like any other guy. Even though her internal thoughts say differently, she's still treating him like her previous lovers. So there's not much development there. There's also not a lot mentioned about Serafina and her two friends' goals towards women's rights. It's just barely touched upon, and I want more of that. And also, I don't know if I mentioned before, but the hero is an architect, and there is just a lot of architecture talk that is quite boring because I don't understand architecture, but he goes on and on about it, and it's just not interesting to read about. So if you couldn't tell, I am having quite the problems with this book, which is so disappointing because this was one of my most anticipated reads of this year. One of the few historical romances that I was so excited for. And this author is also one that I've been really wanting to read. So this first book of hers, it's just not impressing me all that much. Unrelated to the TBR though, to the readathon, I actually just bought myself a book from Penelope Douglas. She was having these sales on these foreign editions for her books that she like had extra copies of and wanted to get rid of. So I bought myself the Portuguese version of Birthday Girl. The cover is so nice. I'll like show it here. So it's like the Birthday Girl cover, but just without the dark gray covering. It's just straight up the girl in the pool, which I love. So I am so excited for that to get here. It was only $5. All of those foreign edition books were all $5, and then plus $5 for shipping. $10 for a signed Penelope Douglas book. Obviously, I'm gonna get it. Hey everyone, it is currently day 4 of the readathon, so it's Thursday, and I have been in my pajamas all day. I sleep in my Jonas Brothers concert t-shirt, but I have finally finished the Raycast. I had to like start speed reading, kind of skimming through stuff just because so boring the first half, but the second half of the book did make up for it a little bit. The book is really long though. It's like unnecessarily long. It's almost 400 pages, but I think they could have taken out a lot of the beginning. I mentioned how Serafina was drinking all the time and she finally got her act together around 60% of the book, and that's when things started picking up in terms of the romance and also like the fighting for women's equality stuff. Like, this is literally what I wanted to read from the book, and I only got it in the last part, in the last 40% of this book. So that's a bit of a disappointment. I'm giving this one 3 stars. I might lower it to 2.5 depending on how I feel by the time I write my review. But yeah, this was not the book that I was hoping for. But I am still kind of looking forward to the next 2 books in the series, in the Society of Sirens series. It's about the 3 best friends, Serafina and her 2 friends, Cornelia and Tyus. I think that's how you pronounce Tyus. I could be wrong. Cornelia and Tyus were still very intriguing characters. They are just as scandalous as Serafina is. One is a prostitute herself. But the second book in the Society of Sirens series is gonna be about Cornelia. The ending of the Raycast is, there's a bit of a cliffhanger, not in terms of a romance, like they have a happily ever after, but like something else outside of that to do with the whole women's equality fight. So I am looking forward to that just so I can see how it's resolved. So the bingo card for the Raycast, I'm gonna check off in a series again, a single parent, because the hero has 2 kids, a daughter and a son. They're so adorable, but I wish they'd shown up more in the book. A rake, of course, for Serafina. Checking off the Scottish Highlander box because Adam is Scottish. And another check mark for the published after 2000 square. So next up is The Governess Game by Tessa Dare, book 2 in the Girl Meets Duke series. That one I'm listening to in audio I'm really excited about it. I need something that's like guaranteed lightheartedness and fun, which Tessa Dare always delivers on. And I'm also gonna be starting on Hearts of Flame, which is our readathon buddy read. I'm not sure I'll have time to start it today. I am gonna be recording on a podcast in a couple hours. It's on the Literally Us podcast, hosted by my friends Cameron and Gabby. They asked me to join on this episode because they were reading Chasing Cassandra and they knew that I'd read Chasing Cassandra. So it's basically gonna be us talking about Lisa Kleypas and a bunch of historical romances, which is very fitting for this week and this readathon. I'm excited. I'm a little scared. I've never recorded on a podcast before. If you listen to podcasts, if you listen to romance podcasts, be sure to check them out. I'll leave a link to their podcast or maybe to our specific episode if they put it up. Hey, you guys, welcome back. I have just finished listening to The Governess Game by Tessa Dare. I'm kind of sad I didn't love it as much as the other two books in the series, which is also the same problem I had with that Beverly Jenkins book. I mean, it's still okay, but it was the hero that brought down the rating for me. I didn't really grow to love Chase. He annoyed me more than not. The book is another single parent, well, single guardian kind of romance with a rake hero. Although now I can check off the titled hero box on the bingo. Chase is the heir to a dukedom, and he's just been granted guardianship of these two young girls. He knows absolutely nothing about being a guardian, much less guardians to girls. So he's trying to hire a governess, Alexandra, also known as Alex. She needs money. Chase needs a governess, so the two of them make a deal. The two of them expressly try to keep their lust out of it, but obviously that doesn't work out. The book also counts as a POC main character because Alex, she's actually maybe a quarter Filipino because one of her parents was a mestiza in the Philippines. But the romance itself, it was pretty cute, pretty sweet, lots of sexy times. Surprisingly happened a lot earlier than I expected to because the two of them don't have any self-control. My problem with this book though, the reason why I'm only giving this one like a 3.5 rating was because of Chase. He is the biggest rake, and they just could not stop talking about his rake-ness. I kind of wanted him to reform a little bit earlier than he did. There's one scene where he's like trying to slake his lust with some other woman that was so annoying. And also, I was annoyed that he just would not step up to be the guardian of those two girls. Those two girls, though, were the saving grace of this book and why I laughed as much as I did. They are such a riot, Rosamund and Daisy. They are two sisters who have been orphaned and they are slightly out of control but in like the cutest and best way ever. They're just trying to create like so much havoc, trying to make Chase's life miserable as a way to protect themselves. But yeah, I love those two girls. They were wonderful, the best part of this book. I just wanted Chase to step up and be the guardian that he needed to be for these girls instead of trying to push them away off onto Alex. I'm also counting this book as a bookish MC square because the heroine is very intelligent and they also first met. Alexandra and Chase first met at a bookshop. They crashed into each other literally and it was a pretty cute meet cute. I am glad to finally have read this book, so I'm now all caught up on the series and I'm really excited for the fourth book to come out. I have also started reading Hearts of Flame by Joanna Lindsay, which is our buddy read. I know Jessica was really enjoying it, so now I'm a little bit more excited. I was a little bit wary going into this because the first and only book that I read from Joanna Lindsay, Once a Princess, I did not like. I gave it 2 stars, but I'm only a couple chapters into this and I'm really enjoying it. I love the heroine, she is badass. Although the beginning is a little bit jarring, I had to double check that the guy that shows up in the beginning is not the hero because he literally wants to rape the heroine. Thank God it's not him. So Hearts of Flame, great so far. We'll probably finish it within the day or by tomorrow. And then I'm also going to be starting on my next audiobook, my last audiobook, Indigo by Beverly Jenkins. This one is a standalone, and I've heard it is a lot of people's favorite Beverly Jenkins book, so I'm really excited about it. It is set during slavery with the Underground Railroad background, because both the main characters are conductors, so they help slaves, escaped slaves, find their freedom. It is very long though, the longest book out of all of these books. The audiobook is almost 14 hours, but since I am going to be listening to it at a pretty high speed, it probably shouldn't take me too long, maybe like 2 days to finish. Unrelated, but I just got some book mail. None are historical romances, but look what I got! I'm so excited. Gallery sent me this finished copy of The Sinner. This is the latest Black Dagger Brotherhood book. I have been waiting for them to send me this ever since Jessica got her copy like 5 days ago. But I guess I can't really blame like UPS for being slower this week, but still I am very excited to have it. I also got the Jet Setters. I cannot remember if I requested this or not, but I mean, this is nice that I can read about traveling without, you know, being able to travel. And then I got Stone Princess by Devney Perry. This is the third book in her Motorcycle Club series. I read the first book. I'm like in the middle of book two, but I put it down. And then another highly anticipated book is The Priest by Tiffany Rice. This is the newest book in the original Sinner series, book 9. I love this series so much. It is my all-time favorite erotica, erotic romance series, BDSM series. The author actually released this early, a month early, so it's out now for everyone to read during this self-isolation time. I also couldn't help myself and bought a bunch of used historical romances online. Jessica put on some link to a used bookstore on her story, and I saw there was a ton of books that I wanted to collect on there for like super cheap. So I ended up buying 9 books for like $22 free shipping. I bought Flowers from the Storm by Laura Kinsale, a book that I've been wanting to read for the longest time. I bought, of course, Lisa Kleypas books 2 and 3 in the Bowstry Runner series, Lady Sophia's Lover, and Worth Any Price, because I already own the first book. I got myself Cold Hearted Rake, the first book in the Ravenel series, and the one book that I do not own yet, the hardcover of Brown Eyed Girl. And then I got 4 Victorian Rebels books, The Hunter, which is book 2, The Duke, book 4, The Scot Beds His Wife, book 5, and then The Duke with the Dragon Tattoo, which is the latest book in the series. So I now have almost all the books in the series. I'm just missing book 3, The Highlander. I've never ordered from Better World Books, but I'm sure it's basically like eBay with like the cheapest shipping box ever. Not even a box. eBay sends in this really flimsy plastic bag. That's it for now. I will probably update you when I finish both Hearts of Flame and Indigo. So I will see you next time. Hi everyone, welcome back. It is the last day of the Historical Romance Readathon, and it is also the day that we will be hosting our live chat, me, Jessica, and Lisa. It'll be happening on my channel, and I'll just leave a link to it, to the finished live chat, in the description below, but it is happening on my channel rather than Jessica's, because there is no cursing on Jessica's channel to protect her kids, and we all know that Lisa will 100% be cursing during the live chat. It'll be Lisa's first time chatting with us, since me and Jessica always chat like once a month with our Ravished by Romance book club. So book updates, I have finished Indigo, and oh my gosh, I love this book so much. It is my favorite book of this readathon. I gave it 5 stars. It was so brilliantly written. I love the romance. Like, yes, it is long and kind of slow, but never boring. The hero is another rake, Galen, but it didn't bother me like it did with a couple of the other heroes that I read this week. And it was because of the way that he just like fell head over heels in love with Hester. Again, they are conductors of the Underground Railroad. Galen is actually known as the Black Daniel, and he's a really powerful figure when it comes to fighting slavery. He is wealthy. He comes from a really wealthy family. He is actually Creole from New Orleans, so he has a delicious French accent. The narrator did a really great job with his French accent. Like, it wasn't too much, but enough to be really hot. Hester and Galen first meet when Galen is injured and brought to Hester, who has a safe house for escaped slaves. So she heals him. He's a bit of a grump, a bit rude to her at first, but then slowly, as they start to talk more, as he's stuck in this house with Hester while he's healing, he becomes so intrigued by her character, and you can easily tell how much he's falling for her. And he just straight up tries to woo her so hard. I was swooning. It was beautiful and magical. So the romance was just, loved it. But the whole Underground Railroad aspect, it was fascinating to read about. It added a lot of suspense and danger to the story. So, you know, the book was never boring. You're always terrified for these people, for the main characters, and the people that they protect. I just think that Beverly Jenkins did an amazing job with this book. Highly, highly recommend it, especially the audiobook. I also finished Hearts of Flame by Joanna Lindsay, and I love this one so much. I'm giving it 4 stars. It wasn't perfect, but it was a fantastic read. I had so much fun reading this one. It's a Viking romance, actually book 2 in the Hardrad series. Book 1 is about the heroine's parents' romance, which I will want to read now after really enjoying this one. But Kristen is the heroine, our Viking daughter, and she is kick-ass, absolutely knows how to defend herself and fight, and she will if she needs to. Unfortunately, when Kristen becomes a stowaway on her brother's Viking ship, she unwittingly becomes part of this fight between the Vikings and the Saxons, and is taken hostage along with a couple other of her people. Royce is her new Saxon lord, and there is some fantastic chemistry between them. Like, yes, she is his slave, but she's never truly one in her heart. Like, she recognizes that he's her heartmate and wants him. I thought it was great. Like, the whole her being his captive thing didn't really bother me as much as I thought it would. Mainly because Kristen is just so awesome that she never comes across as his captive. And I really appreciated that once Royce had Kristen, he never looked at any other woman. She practically had him spellbound, and I love that. So this was a fantastic read. I'm so glad we chose it for the buddy read, and I'm glad that I gave Joanna Lindsay another chance, because my first read from her was not as good. I also actually bought some more historical romance books. Like, a friend on Instagram goes to this bookstore like once a week, and I asked her to find some books for me. So she found a ton of Lisa Kleypas, like the old school editions, and I'm so excited for them. So I spent a bunch of money on books this week, and then now I am also contemplating getting the freaking Nintendo Switch, the Switch Lite, because Animal Crossing is out now, and I'm just dying over people playing it and feeling so jealous. The FOMO is real. Also, KU has a new promo. Amazon has a new promo. I just got it myself. You get 2 months free of KU, but only if you're not currently subscribed. So if your subscription recently ended, like mine did, this is the perfect chance to get 2 more months free. I'll leave a link to the promo if you want it. But that's about it for this historical romance readathon vlog. I'm not sure I'll be able to get to any of the Lisa Kleypas books. I was hoping to get to Devil's Bride, but I'm not sure I'll be able to finish in time, so I'll just save that for a wrap up. I hope you enjoyed watching this video. If you participated in the readathon, I hope you had a lot of fun and that it was able to take your mind off of the current state of the world. Thank you so much for watching, and I'll see you all next time. Bye!